And joining us on Hot Copy, we have Bacolod Mayor Evelio Leonardia. The city is currently experiencing a spike in COVID cases, and there seems to be a clash when it comes to travel rules with certain cities in the Visayas. Mayor, magandang umaga po sa inyo.
Mayong aga, Karen. Mayong aga to all.
All right, let's first talk about the COVID cases in Bacolod City. Can you give me an overview?
Yeah, we had a share of this roller coaster ride, and we are now in our third or fourth wave. We've had very rough times, but you know, like the more recent ones were in September and October, when we had as much as 119 cases a day average. Then it went down to only 20 in November and only 6 in December. And in fact, at the start of January, we in the first week, we had a few days with zero cases. Then all of a sudden, maybe this is the Omicron phenomenon already, we started to hit two figures and then went up to three. And yesterday, we had 235 cases. Now, this is that we're not used to this at all. But the other side of it is in terms of fatalities, for example, when we had it as much as six, an average of six deaths a day way back in September. For the whole month of December, we only had seven. And now up to yesterday, for the whole month of January, we only had seven cases. Now, in terms of the hospital capacity utilization rate, it's just 55%, which tells us then that most of the cases now are symptomatic and mild, much not as much as before when they were more serious and our capacity utilization rate was very high. So even if it is that high, and coupled with our now adjustment to the situation, when we remember 2 years ago when this COVID crisis was new, we were so inclined, we were so biased to give health that much priority. But after it became a protracted battle, we realized that while we care for our health, we cannot totally abandon our concern for the economy. So we are we're trying to have a healthy balance of all this.
Okay, so is it right to say, Mayor, that your numbers technically are still up based on the figures that you've just said?
Yes, as by our standard, we are now having a 93 cases a day average, which, as I said, last month it was only six. Mm-mm. So the other side of it is people are now feel more free to move around, you know, when you proclaim a lockdown. You know, we had four Sundays before when there was total lockdown and nobody could get out of their houses, but now it's quite different.
Yeah. So considering the number of cases, it's interesting to understand why you issued Executive Order 3, wherein you actually lifted the RT-PCR requirement for fully vaccinated inbound passengers from Western Visayas, that's Region 6, Negros Oriental, which falls under Region 7. But clearly you've taken a stand to do away with the RT-PCR tests. If we saw what happened in Boracay over the holidays, the RT-PCR test requirement was removed. There were 6,000 people on the island and many came back home COVID positive. I'm not saying that's the reason why, but wouldn't an RT-PCR test prove as an extra precaution for those traveling to Bacolod?
Well, our travel policies are concerned. We're dealing here with our where the Western Visayas is concerned, and we're dealing with what we should do with Manila. Okay, mm-hmm. In the case of Western Visayas and even Negros Oriental, we realize that we are all in the same alert level, number three. And you know, when you talk about Panay and Negros or Bacolod and Iloilo, that is like you know, we are so interconnected, interrelated, that if we don't have trips between these two destinations, we will feel the impact on the economy for this. So in as much as we are of the same category, and we're trying to improve our economic activities, we decided to lift this requirement. Nevertheless, if one is unvaccinated, we will require him to go rapid antigen test. Now, that is faster, and when you talk about Negros Oriental, considering that we are in the same island, we thought it was going to be logical and practical that we simply just allow them to come in and out. The same way that all the rest, Bacolod is a highly urbanized city. Technically, we're separate and distinct from the province of Negros Occidental, but reality demands that we should somehow consider that situation. And the people, they're so close to us, they come in and out. Now, in the case of Manila, it's a little bit different, because if we continue to require RT-PCR, the laboratories in Manila are overwhelmed. Many times over, the laboratories are not able to submit to their clients or those who are trying to take a flight to Bacolod on time, that requirement of the 72-hour period. So many times they get upset, we get their booking somehow altered, and so many of them are complaining, plus of course the high cost of the RT-PCR test. So we propose to the province, because the airport is located in the territory of the province, in the meantime we follow the rules. So we made a proposal that instead of RT-PCR for the convenience and the ease of these travelers, we should just require the rapid antigen test. So this is a matter that is being scheduled for discussion in a meeting with Governor Bong Lacson tomorrow.
Okay, so you are going against the grain, as some had said. You don't find this to be precarious, considering when you released your executive order, the city reported 266 new cases, all but two local transmissions, because the instinct of some mayors would be to tighten rules and regulations or mobility with these numbers.
Well, I issued a statement that it's about time that we have to learn how to live with the pandemic.
With the virus.
With the virus. And it's been 2 years, and the economy has suffered, and people are not happy with that, for sure. So we thought that this is a chance to prove that as long as we are able to maintain safety protocols, we can continue to live with this. And in spite of the 200 a day experience that we had, we know that we are even better off than many other LGUs. So so this is striking a balance between the economy and health, actually.
Okay, so let's just clarify the travel rules, because it can get confusing for ordinary Filipinos, because each city in the Visayas, you have your own rules. So to clarify, if you are fully vaccinated, partially vaccinated, or partially unvaccinated, as you said, you don't need an RT-PCR. Is that correct?
Yeah, for Western Visayas, as long as you're fully vaccinated, we will not require you RT-PCR nor.
Oo. Pero for Bacolod, pag-usapan natin ang Bacolod, okay. Because many people would travel to Bacolod.
So the question is?
Sa Bacolod, let's say you are unvaccinated, okay. Completely unvaccinated. All you need is an antigen?
No, if you are unvaccinated, we will require you to go antigen.
Okay.
If you're fully vaccinated, then we will not require.
No need. And what about partially vaccinated? You've only had your first dose.
We consider partially vaccinated as unvaccinated. Only fully vaccinated are free.
Mm-mm. All right. So what happens to those crossing between Iloilo and Bacolod, Bacolod to Iloilo? Because what happens is Iloilo has a different set of rules than Bacolod. So you can have one passenger absolutely confused because Iloilo then would require an RT-PCR test for the partially unvaccinated or unvaccinated. Plus, they require an S-pass.
Yeah. If that happens, then admittedly, it might confuse passengers, but technically it means that if they are the ones coming in, we treat them according to our rules, and if we are the ones who will go there to Iloilo, then we will also have to follow the rules. Mm-mm. So if that happens, then we'll have to live with that.
At least. And what is the big issue with Negros Occidental? I mean, clearly you have a clash of ideas in terms of the mobility aspect.
Yes, because we've been receiving a lot of complaints, and this is also admittedly a matter of responding to these concerns. Mm-hmm. And we also see the practicality of the proposal that RT-PCR can be released in a matter of minutes, whereas if you go RT-PCR will require a much longer period.
Yeah. Hours or days.
It's more expensive, yeah. And that is why the actual experience is that people cannot take their flights on time because they cannot get their test results according to the schedule. Now, if we only require them the rapid antigen test, then they can do that within the day.
And, yeah.
As long as, of course, the condition is the RAT must come from an accredited DOH laboratory, not the antigen that the RAT test that individuals do in their homes.
Yes, but then Mayor, you are getting criticism for easing travel restrictions and border control. Dr. Sario of the Philippine College of Physicians in Negros Occidental said that the easing of border restrictions is too soon as the surge is still in its early stage. You're also criticized by the Negros Occidental Vice Governor himself.
Well,
medical experts have also said that your move and your new policy is premature.
No, we feel that it's been so long that we've been having this pandemic, and it's about time that, as I said, we should learn how to live with the pandemic. So we realize that in as much as Omicron is not as virulent as Delta, and people had adjusted, because when you move around Bacolod now, as against what it was during the height of the pandemic, it's a completely different picture. People move around much more free now, and I think it is part of the adjustment process, and you might as well do it as early as we can. That's how we philosophize the situation.
And with the easing of travel restrictions to Bacolod, how many new people, tourists or Balikbayans to Bacolod or those crossing over, how many are you predicting in terms of entering the city?
Well, actually, this is premise that one consideration here is that it's not yet the time when people simply travel because they want to travel. We can see that people travel because of the need, because of economic reasons. So considering that the economic side of the situation, we feel that there's enough some kind of self deterrent there that people who are traveling are not really leisure travelers. They are more because of business.
Yeah.
And you know, the economic side of the story, therefore, is being given away. Because as I said, we've been too long here, and we have to learn how to live with this.
I'm curious in terms of limiting the mobility of the unvaccinated. Does this hold true for Bacolod? Do you have strict measures against the unvaccinated?
We're waiting for results in Manila. As of now, we are not yet fully implementing that, but especially so that it might need an ordinance to do that. So our Sangguniang has not yet acted on that, although our Emergency Operations Center is inclined to make a recommendation that for the consideration of the Sangguniang, that we should now, it's about time that we should have a clear and maybe stricter policy as regards the vaccinated and the unvaccinated.
Yeah. I'm curious how many in the province are vaccinated in terms of percentage?
Let me talk about Bacolod City. The target population, according to DOH, is 70% of the population, which they peg at 590,000. Because we're quite a big city. We're one of the 10 biggest cities outside of Metro Manila. We checked that we are now 127% over the target population, which means that we had already fully vaccinated 523,000 people. Therefore, if the population is 590, it means that we had already reached 88% of the total population. That is more than enough for herd immunity, and that means we're just going to search for 67,000 more people, and we will be 100% vaccinated. So,
where are these 67,000? I'm curious.
They are scattered all over, but mostly they are the ones in the Porox, in the far-flung barangays. But we had established some innovations that we are even doing now house to house campaign.
Okay.
And so we continue, of course, our the balls are still there, and we have night shift vaccination, and in fact we have a 24-hour vaccination in one of the charity stores, which has proven to be also effective, especially during the days. We have a Baxi, which means we have 5 buses that move around with vaccinators, and they go where the people are. They go to the markets, they go to the terminals or even call centers, because it is on the principle that if the Muhammad cannot go to the mountain, let the mountain go to the Muhammad. So if the people cannot go to the vaccination centers, we will make the vaccination centers go to the people. So that is why one of the major factors why we've reached 88% of our total population by now.
Okay, but
what played a role in the? We believe, Karen, that the massive vaccination that we've been doing has something to do with our capacity utilization rate, because of the vaccination effects. Much the people are now not that vulnerable as they used to be.
I know you are still supposed to meet with, I think you have a meeting with Negros Occidental, right? But
Correct.
Then Negros Occidental did issue a statement that they want to open, they want to make sure that the movement of people, vehicles within Negros Occidental will remain smooth. And they've also said it would be impractical to have border controls. But how do you assure that you can curb transmission with you relaxing the need for an RT-PCR test?
Well, this is more applicable to those people coming in from Manila, because in PAP at that point in time, cases in Manila were still rising. Now, as regards Negros Occidental and Bacolod, it would now, given the situation now and given realities that we have realized exactly how to deal with this crisis, admittedly, at the start of this pandemic, we were also concerned and maybe I can even say scared that we instituted border controls.
But right now you are you on alert level 3 already or 2?
3, and that holds already true with the rest of Western Visayas.
So you don't find it dangerous that given you are on alert level 3, you've done the opposite and you relaxed, in effect, travel requirements?
Well, I suppose that is the price we have to pay. But so far, we are checking without mentioning names, we're checking on the records at the we're not doing as bad as the others.
But you mean to say the others in the Visayas?
And even the rest of the Philippines, likewise.
Okay. Well, I think at the end of the day, first, I want to ask you, when it comes to pilot face-to-face classes, did you have some schools in Bacolod who are part of the program?
We did it in Alangilan, which is our farthest barangay from the downtown area, and it's we suspended it when we went to alert level 3, but it was doing fine. But in fact, a very small group though, because two classes of 20 students each, so they were doing all right. It was leading to normalization, but then when we went to alert level 3, that was one of the things that we instituted.
Okay, and right now, of course, pilot face-to-face classes, I'm curious, even in Bacolod, has been suspended?
Yeah, we suspended that, but we are now reevaluating that.
I see. So you might, the pilot school, you might start again. Are all the teachers, your teachers, they're required to be fully vaccinated?
There is no legal requirement, but we encourage them.
Okay. What about your health workers?
Yes. By natural course of things, they get themselves vaccinated. Of course, one of the reasons why we have problems sometimes with our healthcare utility facilities is because as of the last count, 121 health workers have been infected. So that has an impact on the functionality of our COVID beds.
Okay. So I think at the end, as we close, how do you assure your neighbors that you've made the right decision, Mayor? That you won't be the cause or you won't be the tipping point to transmissions spreading all over the Visayas region with your new rules?
Well, we feel that we are in the same boat right now in Western Visayas. So what is happening here in Bacolod and what is happening in Western and the rest of Western Visayas is just therefore technically the same. So transferring from either of these two islands is just, if you are from Bacolod and you go to Iloilo, that presupposes that you have the same environment, and so vice versa. Yeah. So it's all about trying to adjust to this now. And as long as we continue to pursue our basic health protocols and make it now a habit to have our masks, our social distancing and all this, we feel that we can overcome this. So this is some kind of a risk, but this will be a faster adjustment to normalization. And that is why we keep on harping on the principle that we have to learn how to live with the virus.
But you are aiming for a more harmonized policy.
At the same time, that's why we are seeking this dialogue with the governor and the officials of the province, so that hopefully we can come into terms and we will not get people confused and we can give more convenience to our travelers.
Okay. On that note, thank you very much, Mayor, for joining me today. I appreciate it.
Thank you very much for having me, Karen. I'm looking forward to the next.
All right. You stay safe.
Salamat. Stay safe too. Good morning.
Maraming salamat po, sir. Thank you. Thank you.